to the 1,000th episode of iSnark TV. I'm Brian Michael Page, our friendly neighborhood iSnark. I want to mention something I forgot to mention. A couple of things, really, about the revamping of my pet project, Psalm 151, that we talked about in the last video. And that is accompaniment. Ideally, the entire work that we presented in the last episode should be done a cappella. However, you can use an organ accompaniment, but you really don't need to put much on them. I don't put much on them at all. For the initial intonation in the verses, simply 8 and 4 foot flutes, fairly light flutes, really. 8 and 4 foot flutes. If you're playing a 3-manual instrument, you could use the swell or the choir. You really don't need any more than that. Compared to some of my other work, namely my own hymn playing, I've been a little bit more minimal as of late when it comes to accompanying of chant and chant-style work. For the People's Antiphon, if your great 8-foot principal or diapason isn't too heavy, feel free to add it to your flutes. If the principal is too heavy, I would also recommend a good strong viola da gamba. It works out at Sacred Heart because I'm playing the Rogers. The principal, you know, works out quite nicely. It blends in very well. Most diapasons are very punchy. Now, at a parish like Holy Name in Providence, where I served 4 very happy years at the turn of the century, the gallery open diapason on the hook in Hastings is quite heavy. So I would, in that case, I would most likely use the viola da gamba instead. Oh, by the way, if I was to say that I was an organist at the turn of the century 12 years ago, you'd probably think I was full of crap, and you'd be right. Now, for the final antiphon, in addition to the viola da gamba and the flutes, I would probably, just for that finale, add a 4-foot octave. You know, and that octave, of course, is also a principal, by the way. I kind of like that that mysterious effect with the responsories like these. I used somewhat similar registrations when we sang the Grassi Magnificat, which is the Magnificat you're about to hear in just a little bit. But first, I have in front of me today's iSnark Top 10 list.
Boom, boom, boom. 10 little 8 little snarks. 7 little 6 little 5 little snarks. 4 little 3 little 2 little snarks. 1 little snark.
Yes, here it is on video. The top 10 least popular titles for new mass settings brought to you by
Who Gives a Damn?
Many different masses are out now using the new translation. And, of course, these are all written in many different styles. Chant, traditional metrical hymnody type. And then, of course, there's the hootenanny type and all that garbage, your typical greatest hits fare, you know. So yeah, there's many different styles, some suitable, some unsuitable for use in a real Catholic context. We at iSnark have managed to come up with some of the least popular titles. We did our own little research. So, from the home office in Doggy Bag, Rhode Island, here are the top 10 least popular titles for new mass settings. Here we go. Number 10, mass based on umpteen gathering rites. Number 9, gathering mass based on gather us in. Number 8, mass written at Jack in the Box. Number 7, mass in honor of the Roadrunner. Number 6, the sequel to the old Boston Celtics mass, the Boston Red Sox mass. Number 5, the Hootenanny mass. Oh, wait, that already happens in many parishes. Number 4, mass written by 4 guitar players who only know 3 chords. Number 3, mass written by 3 guitar players who only know 4 chords. Number 2, mass based on stories I read on the toilet. And the number 1 least popular title for a new mass setting, mass based on John Cage's 433. Now, the piece you're about to hear is the Magnificat that is found at numbers 90 and 91 in the Pius X hymnal. Number 90 on the left-hand page is simply psalm tone 8G. Number 91 uses the same opening line, Magnificat Anima Mea Dominum, to the same tone 8G, but the rest of the verses are written in polyphony by Ciro Grassi. We alternated in this fashion, okay? The Magnificat Antiphon, first of all, is intoned by yours truly. and then repeated by the three of us. Yes, there was a soprano and alto that was singing with me, Elaine and Kate. Then the verses alternate between the grassi, sung by the soprano and alto as a duet, and the tone 8, sung by moi. Then all three of us sing the antiphon once again at the very end. So without further ado, here is the Magnificat, alternating between psalm tone 8G and the music of Sira Grassi.
Thank you.
Folks, don't forget to check out our website, isnarkmedia.blogspot.com, where you can find all the show notes you need for every podcast and videocast I've done since a little bit more than a month before my wife and I quit smoking. You'll find links to our Brother Snark sites, Christos Vinci Music, where you can find original music for Catholic worship, and our flagship site, Christos Vinci at the Blog. You will also find a link to the new Fans of the iSnark page on Facebook, where we keep our Facebook friends abreast of the goings-on at the studio. Want to be part of the action? Just click on the link to Fans of the iSnark and hit the like button up top, and you are in like Flint. Liturgy, music, and fun infesting Facebook. I want to thank you for watching. On our next episode, we'll feature this.
Let's dig deep in the archives for Catholic Lost 45. Let's dig deep in the archives for Catholic Lost 45.
iSnark presents Catholic Lost 45s, where you can find songs and hymns that you have not heard in a long time but wish you could hear again. You'll find us only on iSnark.
Catholic Lost 45.
Until then, I'm Brian Michael Page. Peace.
Made on a crappy PC.